Okay, so today we are going to take a four-wheel combination lock, which are fairly popular out there, and I've already made a video explaining how to bypass and how to decode them. But not too many people know what they look like on the inside, and so therefore, fully understanding what you're doing when you're bypassing or decoding can be difficult. So we're going to cut one of these bad boys open and see how they work. And through the magic of television, we have one. So let's go ahead and take this guy off. That was just for a picture. And I'm gonna take this top piece off. The sole purpose of this is to hold these two guys in place. And what these do is they slide in and out, and there's a spring between them. And these things are what actually lock into the grooves of the shackle. So normally, these things are sprung outward into the shackle, holding the shackle down. And there's this little locking paw. Let's go ahead and remove these guys. Since I just bent the spring. Awesome. Let's remove this. Now this one has a little bit different design on it, and this is designed to interact with this little locking paw. There you can kind of see like the insert, a tab A and a slot B type deal. And what it does is that holds these things outward, and then when the lock unlocks, this springs outward like that and gets out of the way between the two and allows them to spring inward and therefore out of the shackle. That's really bugging me. Okay. So, let's take this thing apart further, but before I go any further, we're going to look at this little piece of metal. And all this does is interiorly, is that a word? You can see how this thing has little fingers that spring downward. All this does is without this, these wheels can free spin. And all this does is this rests against the wheels internally and gives the iconic ratcheting aspect that you are probably familiar with these locks. That is the sole purpose of this piece of metal. So let's take this cover off. Now there is a small spring on this side, and we'll go over that in a minute. Because your rekey, the little key that you stick through that hole, goes through this slot into here. And again, we'll go over that a little bit later. So we'll take that spring out. There's like a spindle in there we got to pull out. Okay, man, here we go. Take a look at one of these little wheels. All right. So, in the video where I show you how to decode the wheel, I had the theoretical model that showed a flat side and a small groove that you're looking for. This is what it actually looks like. It's actually fuzzy and slightly out of focus like that in the lock. Wow, this is amazing technology. Okay, here we go. So we have the flat side, which is important for unlocking. It's not a false gate. And then we have the small gate that we use to decode the lock. So when you're sticking that thin piece of metal down the side of the wheel, you're feeling for that piece of metal, which is always going to be between two numbers. In this case, it's between the four and the five. So in the video, we would find out which two numbers that is between, they would be oriented straight up. Then we would, in this case, again, focus. Come on. Forget it. Anyway, so we're just going to pretend this is in focus. So this is right now. God damn, that thing is really back. Okay. Wish there was a way to lock the focus on this thing. Anyway, so between the 4 and the 5, we would roll it down to the 5, and then we would rotate it two whole numbers, which what we're doing is that is actually orienting the small groove on the very bottom and orienting the flat spot on the very top. Now, the reason that is important is let's go ahead and take the rest of these wheels out. All these wheels are identical, so it's really not important to go over them all. And then being identical is pretty neat because they could add a fifth or a sixth, seventh, or even an eighth wheel if they wanted to in the future. So, why is the flat spot important? Because of this locking paw. Remember I told you that when the lock is unlocked, this paw springs out of the way and therefore lets these two guys spring inward and out of the shackle. So, when you're bypassing, well, let's not go to bypassing first. Let's finish my first thought. So the flat spot, when you're decoding or when you put in the correct combination, what happens is you let all four wheels orient in a manner that the flat spots are up, and that gives just enough room for this paw to move out of the way. Now, if one or more of the wheels isn't rotated correctly, of course, it's going to try to fall apart now that the shaft isn't in there. Let's say that it's not oriented correctly. Well, the paw can't move. So when all four wheels are rotated in a manner that the flat spot is straight up, there is more room in there, and this thing is allowed to move out of the way, like so. So that is what's going on internally when you are decoding. So let's talk about bypassing. Bypassing is when you're sticking the small or thin piece of metal, but you know, on the side of one of the wheels, and you are getting it under this piece of metal, and then you are moving your piece of metal upward, kind of like in that fashion. And what you're doing is you're manually stretching that spring and moving that little paw out of the way. And that's all you're doing in bypassing. Now, it is common when you're trying to get the piece of metal in there that you get the metal stuck between the top of the paw and the outer body of the lock. Obviously, that's not what you want. You need to angle it down a little bit more to get under that piece of metal. So that's what's going on when you're bypassing. And we saw with the wheels and the slots what's going on when you're decoding. So if you're having a hard time finding that small groove when you're decoding, but you tend to have a pretty good success rate of finding the flat spot, it doesn't matter which one you find, but you know what this looks like now. You know that the small groove following the video needs to be on the very bottom, and now you know that if you constantly keep finding the large flat spot, that you know that the flat spot needs to be perfectly flush with the with this side of the lock. So if you're looking at the bottom of the lock with the keyhole on the left side with the numbers oriented, you know, perfectly like that, the flat spot needs to be facing that direction. So that is what's going on when you're decoding. So now let's go over the spring. So how do you change the combination of these? Well, obviously this piece, you've probably seen it already, comes apart. And what you have is you have like a little geared washer in there. And this piece, I'll just do it on the floor. This piece has two little teeth in there. It's keyed. And that interacts with the teeth of that little washer. So when you push the key in from the side, you're actually pushing the shaft toward that side of the lock, and this pushes the wheels away from that keyed, or from the teeth on this thing, and that allows the wheels to turn. And so when you turn in the new combination, you pull the key out, and the spring on the other side pushes everything back and re-engages with these teeth. So that's how the re-key mechanism works. It's fairly simple. I'm actually fairly impressed that this lock is a lot more complicated internally than I thought it would be. But That's how it works. That's what it looks like inside. Hopefully that gives you a better understanding as to what's going on when you're bypassing or when you're decoding or when you're rekeying or anything like that. So if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Peace out.